Aki Kareem, British boxers. We're over at Rob Rimmer's Phoenix Camp. Got Mark Efron with us, number two on BoxRec. how you doing, mate?
Yeah, I'm doing good, man. Just finished sparring though, Mark Jeffers. Got some good rounds in. Yeah, everything's going good. Looking forward to my fight now, August 31st.
I watched the spar. Well, I watched the first round and the last round. Mm-hmm. They both had the same intensity.
Yeah.
And that last round, there was some heavy duty leather going in from both of you.
Yeah.
Very entertaining spar, mate.
Yeah, he's a good spar. He's a good, good strong lad, Mark. Yeah, got some good rounds out of him there.
I was just speaking to him there, and he said it's a great experience to be in there with you. You're not a veteran in the sport by any means, but you are quite a seasoned guy now, aren't you, really?
Yeah, of course I am, yeah. I've been professional now for years, haven't I?
Yeah.
Obviously, I have my little setbacks and stuff, but everything's going good now. I'm feeling good, I'm enjoying it, yes. Everything's going good. I'm just looking forward to the 31st now and then hopefully we won some big titles.
Yeah. Just watching you there working away with Rob, there's something that I've noticed, you know, in the speeds actually.
Yeah.
Is that something you've been working on recently? Because you've always had the power, we know that, but the speed's looking there as well now.
Yeah, I'm working on a lot of stuff from all the inside work, speed, yeah, but the main key is my jab in it, my jab going. That's something I've never really used before and something I am using a lot now.
I know you're happy with your elevated position to number two in BoxRec. But with that comes all sorts of things because you become a target man as well for other people who want your ranking, don't you? So are you looking forward to more of the domestic clashes?
Well, like the British title?
The British.
Yeah, I'm open to offers, man. Whatever title comes up, I'll jump at it, yeah. But I like the Commonwealth. Felix Cash has got that, hasn't he? Mm. And the British. William's got that, but I think William's moving on now, hasn't he? So yeah, I'm looking to head towards him, yeah.
Talking to Felix.
And the European titles, the EU European title as well, that's on the way as well, so see what happens.
In terms of time frames, you talked about a few good routes for you to go there.
Yeah.
What sort of time frames are you looking at?
What, for the titles?
Yeah, for these title fights. I know you've got another fight coming up in August on the Black Flash show. Are you talking about the fight after that?
Yeah, I fight August 31st and it's October 12th, is it? I think it's October 12th, so I don't know what that is, whether it's
Josh Warrington.
Yeah, Josh Warrington, yeah. So I don't know whether that's a title or it's going to be an 8-rounder or a 10-rounder, I'm not sure, but
You like those Josh Warrington undercards, don't you?
Yeah, it's mint.
You're on the line, it's a great atmosphere, always a great atmosphere.
Always a great atmosphere, yeah. It's mint, yeah.
Tell us a bit about the Black Flash show. This is in Oldham, isn't it?
Yeah, back in Oldham. Looking forward to it, back in my hometown. Pat always puts a good show on. So yeah, I'm looking forward to it.
And of course, you always sell a lot of tickets in Oldham. You always sell a lot of tickets anyway you go to
be honest, a lot of people have been letting me down, actually, for this fight. Waiting for the title fight, that's what they're saying, like, they keep waiting for the title fight. So, but I don't know when the title fight's going to be, whether it's going to be next time or in the year, so get your tickets.
Yeah, get your tickets. Or you can also, I believe, Pat's trying something new with this one and streaming it on an MMA channel.
Yeah.
On a pay-per-view type of format.
Yeah.
So they can go down that avenue as well.
All right.
So one thing I've noticed though, you know, every time I come down here, you're sparring someone different and new.
Yeah, yeah.
So actually, people are getting experience with you, but you've been in there with lots of different styles, haven't you?
That's the good thing about Robert, is he's busy, he's always on the ball, he's always wanting to try new things, and that's one thing that other trainers are lacking, putting the work in, you know what I mean, and getting on the phone and ringing up for new sparring partners and getting new people in. So that's what Rob's good at as well. Obviously, he's a good trainer and stuff. But yeah, he's always on the ball.
Talking of you know, people you sparred, and you also mentioned Felix Cash yourself there. Yeah. Did you catch Jack Cullen? His fight.
Yeah, he's got a good performance. The guy boxed. I sparred him a few. Fought the guy. The lad.
Oh, John. John Harding Jr.
Yeah, sparred him on down at his gym. He was good, decent fight. Yeah, but, Jack Cullen put a good performance in there.
So you're keeping aware of all the divisions.
100%. Yeah, 100%.
What's the situation with if you end up having to fight someone that you know quite well, or you know, maybe even a mate or something?
Yeah. Business, isn't it? It's, whatever fight gets offered, you gotta take, can you? Mates or not, do you know what I mean?
Yeah, man. Well, you've had, like you say, you've had that one glitch, but it looks like all guns are blazing now, and you're ready to get back to, you know, your former.
Yeah, definitely, glory. Yeah. The Williams have got a lot of experience out of that. Williams a world class fighter, and you see what he's done to his last two opponents, do you know what I mean? And obviously, I went 10 rounds with him with a perforated eardrum, but obviously that's not no excuses, you know what I mean, if you can beat me fair and square. But from round two I had a perforated ear, so it was like I was in a deja vu all the way through the fight. But let's move on now.
Yeah. Well, you know, people that support you haven't stopped, you know, it's, you know, you've got very good support.
Definitely.
Support base, and I think we're excited to see you know, all the learning that you'll do from that experience. And you know, you certainly haven't lost any of that power, have you?
Nah.
All right, mate. Any final like shout outs to anyone?
Yeah, I just want to say thank you for all the support of everyone getting tickets off me, coming to my fight with your hard money. Yeah, thank you very much to everyone, and thanks to all my sponsors as well for sticking with me. Thank you.
All right, mate. Good luck in your next fight. I'm sure I'll see you before then anyway.
Yeah, thank
take
you.
Take care, man.